Hey, Mom, Dad.
Brian, Stacy, your mother Ellen and I are so glad you decided to join us for this family communication session.
So, what's up? You guys getting divorced or something?
No, we just wanted the family to talk as a group.
Okay, well, let's get it started then.
All right, well, your father and I are a little bit concerned. Celia, the cleaning lady, was in the family room and she found a bag of pot.
Now, we're not here to come down on you. I mean, that's not what we're about, okay?
We're just concerned that pot could lead to other things. But we know you don't want to hear this from us.
Sure, I mean, we're your parents. Who wants to hear this stuff from their parents, huh?
But your father and I came up with a brilliant idea to give you kids some direction. A motivational speaker.
Yeah, one of those guys who speaks to big groups at high schools and churches. Now, he's been down in the basement drinking coffee for about the last 4 hours, and he should be all ready to go. I'll call him up. His speech is called Go For It. Now, he's used to big groups, so make him feel like there's a crowd here. Come on up, buddy!
All right, how's everybody? Good, good, good. Now, as your father probably told you, I am a motivational speaker. Now, let's get started by letting me give you a little bit of a scenario of what my life is all about. First off, I am 35 years old.
Scrape my heart up off the floor. My attitude is so much better.
I am divorced.
And I hardly ever cry the way I did before. I've been living it up
in a van down by the river.
Having myself bedtime. Living it up
in a van. Down by the river.
Living out all those fantasies I never did get to.
Now you kids are probably saying to yourselves,
those crazy things I never got to do.
Today I'm gonna go out and I'm gonna get the world by the tail.
Got myself a new persona.
Wrap it around and pull it down and put it in my pocket.
Put a service all back up.
Well, I'm here to tell you that you're probably gonna find out, as you go out there, that you're not going to amount to jack squat in a van down by the river. In a van down by the river. You're gonna end up eating a steady diet of government cheese and living in a van down by the river. Now, young man, what do you want to do with your life?
Kind of want to be a writer.
Well, la-dee frickin' da! We got ourselves a writer here! Hey, Dad, I can't see real good. Is that Bill Shakespeare over there?
Huh? Well, actually, Alan and I have encouraged Brian in his writing.
Dad, I wish you could just shut your big yapper!
Every now and then I must confess.
Now I wonder,
not quite up to all this happiness.
Brian, from what I've heard,
sometimes I wonder if the place I'm at is where I do belong.
You're using your paper not for writing, but for rolling doobies in a van down by the river. In a van,
right from the women to the wild,
down by the river. You're gonna be doing a lot of doobie rolling,
but it don't seem like living without you
when you're living in a van.